Hello students, topic for today is doctrine of severability. So doctrine of severability means the separation. Purpose of Article 13 of Indian Constitution means to separate the valid portion of the law from the invalid provisions. The main object of the doctrine is to retain the act or legislation in force by discarding and deleting the void provisions. So whatever part in the act is not a valid part and which is inconsistent, is invalid, will be removed and the remaining portion will be retained. So Article 13(1) is declaring it that the whatever law that has been there before the commence, immediately before the commencement of the Constitution, if it is inconsistent with the fundamental rights, then it will be inconsistent. With the inconsistency, it will be a void law. So the part of the statute is inconsistent with Part 3 alone shall be declared void. So this protects our fundamental rights, and as it is mentioned in Clause 1 of Article 13(1) of the Constitution, that all laws in force in India before the commencement of the Constitution in so far will be inconsistent with the provisions of fundamental rights to the extent of the inconsistency and will be void. But the whole law or act would not be held invalid. Only the provisions of the law or act which are not inconsistent, which are not inconsistency with the fundamental rights will be invalid. But it is only possible if the part which is inconsistent with the law is separated from the whole law. So this part, inconsistent part, is to be separated from the whole law. If both the valid and the invalid part are very closely mixed up with each other, then it cannot be separated, then the whole law or the act will be held invalid. A few cases are A.K. Gopalan versus the State of Madras, State of Bombay versus the F.N. Balsara, Mineral Miles versus the Union of India, RMDC versus the Union of India. So this is a landmark judgment which has completely observed the doctrine of severability. In this, it was observed that in determining whether the valid parts of a statute are separable from the invalid parts thereof, it is the intention of the legislator that the determining factor, the test to be applied, is whether the legislature would have enacted the valid part if it had not known that the rest of the statute was invalid. If the valid and the invalid provisions are so mixed up that they cannot be separated from one another, then the invalidity of the portion must result in the invalidity of the whole act. On the other hand, if they are distinct and can be separated after striking out what is invalid, the remaining self will be independent of the rest, and it will be that the rest has become unenforceable. Even when the provisions which are valid and distinct and are separate from those which are invalid, then if they all form a part of single scheme which is intended to be operative as a whole, then also the invalidity of the part will result in the failure of the whole. Likewise, when the valid and the invalid parts of a statute are independent and they do not form part of the scheme, but what is left after omitting the invalid portion is so thin truncated as to be thus in substance different from what it was when it emerged out of the legislature, then also it will be rejected in its entirety. The separability of the valid and invalid provisions of the statute does not depend on whether the law is enacted in the same section of different sections, or it is not the form but the substance of the matter that is material, and that has to be ascertained on an examination of the act as a whole or of the setting of the relevant provisions therein. If after the invalid portion is expunged from the statute, what remains cannot be enforced without making alterations and modification therein, then the whole of it must be struck down as void, as otherwise it will amount to judicial legislation. In determining the legislative intent on the question of separability, it will be legitimate to take into account the history of legislation, its object, the title and preamble to it. Thank you.